Morning everybody. Hi, my name's Karen. I'm the founder of Creative Yogis and I'm coming to you live from Australia now. Thank you so much for joining me this morning for a family yoga session. I'm really excited to be here again and I'd like to say a really big thank you to Oscillation Yoga Community for inviting me to join you this morning. So I'm wondering how everybody's feeling today. It's a beautiful Sunday here, and Sundays are really nice because for me, it's that kind of day where I really enjoy connecting with my family and friends. So it's perfect for us to be doing our family yoga session today. So one thing I wanted to ask you to do this morning before we start is for all the kids to see if you can go and grab your favorite toy. It could be, you know, whatever it is for you. I've got a few of my favorite toys around me here. But I'd like you kids, if you could just go and grab a toy now. I'll wait for just a minute for you to go and do that. And then when you've found your favorite toy, let's bring it back and we'll place it by the mat so that at the end today, when we do our relaxation, we can have a beautiful breathing buddy and it can be your favorite toy today. So I'm just going to give you a second to do that, and mums and dads that are here joining me today, I'd like to welcome you to the class as well while the kids are running around getting their toys. And I think it's a really great opportunity for me to just remind you about really being mindful of your own body today when we're doing yoga together. And even though maybe the children can do a few other things that we might not be able to do as adults, we're all listening to our body, we're being mindful, we're being safe, and we're having a really, really wonderful time together. So that's important. Just to remember that, okay? And for everyone to check in with themselves and tune in this morning. So hopefully, kids, you've come back. I didn't even introduce my toy, did I? So this is my beautiful bear, and he's called Bounce. And the reason he's called Bounce is because he has the ability to go into lots of different yoga poses. You might have even seen a bear like this before. So he's really, really great to have around. And I hope you've all got your favorite toy with you today now. Okay, so today's pretty exciting because we are going on a treasure hunt. So it's a bit of an adventure today. And any adventure is a little bit of a mystery, isn't it? Because we don't know what we're going to find. So just to be sure that you're listening and you're looking and you're seeing what we can find together today. But we are going in search of treasure, and we are going to go to an island. So I think before we go, we might just make sure that we're really listening, and we're going to play a listening game together. And this is my beautiful mindfulness friend, Chili the Frog. And he travels all over the world with me, actually. He hasn't been to Malaysia yet, but hopefully he'll be there later in the year to see you guys. And what I really love about frogs, what they teach me is about being peaceful and mindful, actually. Because frogs have the ability, I'm sure you guys know this already, they can leap very, very high, but they can also sit very peacefully on a lily pad, watching everything that's going on around them, but they don't need to do anything. They're very mindful, just sitting and watching. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna see if we can play the listening game by using our ears and really tuning into sound. Now, I'll put Chili down for a minute. So what we're going to use is, I've got my special bells. These are called tinctures, and they make a really fantastic sound. Just listen for a minute. And it's a sound that keeps going, keeps vibrating, doesn't it? You can hear it getting less and less and less until it disappears. So the game is how well you can listen to this sound, okay, but you're going to have your eyes closed and your ears really open and listening really well. And when there's no sound, no bell, I want you to reach up as if you could touch the sky with your hand, okay, to let me know that you know there's no sound. So let's try that together. Can you see if you can sit up really tall, not be all squashed? See if you can sit up really, really tall, even for a minute. Can you take hold of an imaginary string on top of your head, reaching up, pulling up? Wow, well done, everybody, you just got taller. Okay, now let go of that string, but stay really tall. Now, closing your eyes, opening your ears, and listening for a sound, listening for the bell, okay? Here we go. Fantastic, well done everybody. I could feel how well everybody was listening. Okay, so because we've done it once, let's try it again. See if you can, this time I want you to see if you can raise the other hand into the air. Okay, you ready? All right, focusing, opening your ears, closing your eyes, getting ready. Here we go. Beautiful. Well done, everybody. That was amazing. Even Chili, I think Chili was impressed as well, actually. So I'm just going to pop Chili back over here. And what Chili teaches us again is how to listen. It's not easy, is it, to listen? I know even for mums and dads, for aunties, kids, it's not easy. So we're just going to keep practicing, okay? And Chili's teaching us that today. Oh, now actually, I can hear something. Can hear something in the distance. I'm sure there's a rainstorm coming. Can you rub your hands together? That's it. Just for a minute. Start to rub your hands. See if you can feel some heat. Now, I think that's the wind. I can hear the wind in the distance. Now, can you start to tap your hands onto your legs? That's it. Keep tapping with me. Oh my goodness, it's raining. Oh no, it's starting to really rain. Oh, it's pouring, absolutely pouring. Hang on a minute, I can hear some lightning. Clap your hands. Oh my goodness, I can hear thunder. Stamp your feet. I can hear lightning. Clap your hands. I can hear thunder. Stamp your feet. Oh my goodness, it's still raining. Oh, I don't know if we can go on our adventure yet. It's still raining. It's pouring. Hang on a minute. Listen. It's slowing down. Slowing down. It's raining a little bit less. And now. Oh. Hang on, I can hear the wind again. Rub your hands. Slow it down. Slow it down. Oh, that was a big rainstorm. Just came right over. I thought I could see it in the distance. Lucky we didn't go on our adventure yet. Whew, but my goodness, that was a big rainstorm. I don't know about you, but I just need to have a moment here to catch my breath. Oh, so open your arms really wide for a moment. Oh. Let's count to three together. Are you ready? One, two, three. Clap your hands. Rub your hands together. And then put your hands onto your tummy and take a breath in. Big breath and then breathing out through your mouth. Oh, that feels a little bit better. Open the arms wide again. Let's count to three again. One, two, three. Clap your hands. Rub your hands together again. That's it, keep rubbing them. Well done, everybody. Place your hands onto your heart. Take a big breath in and breathing out. Wow. I think, whew, that's calmed us down a little bit, getting ready for our adventure now. Now, I'm feeling excited. Could you stand up with me today? Can you see if you can just take your feet like train tracks, maybe put your hands in front, slowly bring yourself back up to standing. Fantastic. I thought we might do a little bit of an affirmation shout out. Now, affirmations are when we use positive words that make us feel really great. Now, I can tell that we're excited today to go on an adventure. I know I am. So I thought we might shout out, we are excited. And we might punch the air with our hands as we do it. Okay, so we're going to breathe in, reach our hands out in front, clap our hands, bring our hands back. We're going to shout out, you ready, and punch out, we're excited. Oh my goodness, let's do it again. Hands out in front, clap your hands. Hands back to center, breathing in, ready. We're going to punch out, shout out, we are excited. Last time, hands out in front. Clap your hands, hands to your chest, breathing in. We are excited. Oh my goodness, I could see you guys getting excited. I'm excited and it's time to warm ourselves up. I feel like an adventure means we need to have a little bit of a dance before we get ready to do all of our poses and see what we're going to find on our adventure. Let's just see if we can get ready. Hang on a minute, my speaker's just gone to sleep on me. Sorry everyone, he's gonna wake up. That's what happens sometimes. Sorry everyone, give me a second. Apologies. Here we are, we're getting ready. Okay, here we are. Walking on the spot. Walking forwards. Warming up, backwards. And then again, reach your arms up. And then backwards. Take your arms down, jump your feet up high. Circles. That's it, well done. Wake your hips up, everybody. Brilliant. And back the other way. Big circles. Breathing in, stretching up. Side stretches. Well done, everyone. Back to the center. Back to the center again. Arms all the way down. Helicopters. Punch your hands forward a little bit and swing your hips. Reach up and clap your hands. Come all the way down. Come onto your bottom. And cycle. Get your legs working, warming up. Well done. And backwards. Coming up, reaching your hands up, touching your toes, rolling back down. Happy babies. Moving your legs and your arms in the air. Fantastic. Coming up, hands behind you, lifting up, belly buttons to the sky. Coming back down. One more time, coming up, give a high five. Feet to the ground, bumps to the ground. Coming up again, breathing in, high five. Feet to the ground, bumps to the ground. Make yourself into a little ball. We're gonna do some little rolls. We're gonna do five, get ready. Here we go. And go. There's one. And two. And three. And four. And five. One more. And six. Swinging around. Breathing in, reaching up. Breathing out. Arms back down. Reaching up, over to the side. Back to the center. Reaching up. And changing. Center. And changing. Back to the center. And then changing. Clap your hands and bring your hands back to the center. Well done, everybody. Fantastic. Well, I feel warmed up. I don't know if you guys do. I hope you do. Brilliant. All right, so off on our adventure today. Now, the first thing we're going to need to do is we're going to have to see if we can get into the boat. We're off on our boat. So can you take your legs out in front and let's just see if we can start to row out to the boat. We're going to get in a small boat to start with. All right, we're going to do 10 rows, okay? So we're going to touch our toes, okay, everybody? And then we're going to row back. Here goes one, touch your toes. And two, use those tummy muscles. Three, there we go, four, and again. Five, keep going, you're doing really well. Six, there we go, seven, keep going. Eight, my goodness, nine. Oh, hold it there, and one more, 10. And then coming all the way back. Oh, well done, fantastic. Now we're gonna climb, that's it. Take your legs behind you. We're climbing up onto the boat, and then we're gonna see what our sea legs are like. So can you come onto your hands and knees, and let's see if we can find our sea legs today. Now, on the boat, it's moving around, it's rocking around a little bit, so we're going to see if we can balance. Can you stretch one leg behind? Can you lift it into the air? Now, here comes your challenge. Can you reach the other hand out in front? And we're going to count to five. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five. Well done, everyone. Hands down, knees to the floor. Really open up your hands when you've got your hands on the floor. Have your knees a little bit apart. Stretch the other leg behind you. Lift it up. That's it. Well done. Now see if you can reach your arm out. Trying your sea legs on the other side. We're going to count to five. One, two, three, four, five. You're doing so well. And then bring your hands and your knees back to the floor. Oh my goodness, that was amazing. All right, let's see if we can get up to standing now because we've found our sea legs because it's a little bit rough on the ocean today. All right, let's come up, lifting up, and let's walk our feet towards our hands, slowly coming all the way back up. Well done, everybody. Okay. I can see right to the top of the ship. So let's see if we can make the shape of our boat today. Can you take your hands out in front? Breathe in here, jump your feet apart. Hands behind your head, bend your knees. Breathing in, jump your feet together. Breathe in, are you ready? Breathe out. One more time, breathe in, breathe out. Here we go, last time, breathing in, breathing out. Hands onto your hips. Can you turn your back foot out? Turn your front foot to face this way. All right, now let's see if we can look up to the mast, the sail of our boat. Reach your arms out, stretching. Take your hand down and then see if you can point the sail all the way up. Fantastic. Well done. There's a flag right on top there. That's our flag for our ship today on our adventure. And then can you come all the way back up and see if you can clap your hands. Well done. Hands on your hips. Turn your feet parallel. Reach your hands up. Clap your hands again. Hands out in front. Hands on your hips. Back foot turns out. Front foot faces this way. Okay, you're doing a brilliant job today. I can feel everybody. Reach out. If you could grab the other side of the room and take your hands down, shooting the top of the mast all the way up to the clouds. Fantastic, everybody. Brilliant, well done. And then coming up, all the way up, clap your hands, turn your feet parallel, hands behind your head, and then jump your feet together. Now I'm wondering today what your family crest, because you're on this boat together as a family, what it would look like. I know for me, for my family, it would be a big love heart with lots of stars around it, because we all love hearts and stars in my family. So I'd love to know what you guys would put onto your flag. Now, right above, all around the top of the sail are the huge, big seagulls. They're always around, aren't they? So let's see, we can see one sitting right on the top. I'm gonna show you from the side what your seagull looks like. And I want you to see if you can bend your knee a little bit here, bend your leg, and then see if you can bring your foot just resting. It's a tricky one. If you can't do it there, you can always just put your foot down here. And can you take your feathers and your wings out to the side? That's it. See if you can find your seagull for a minute here. Let's count to 3, 2, 1. Okay, brilliant. Now put your foot back down. I'm going to turn and face you now. Let's see how we get on the other side. All right, so here we go, seagulls. You remember, you're going to see if you can bend your knee a little bit and see if you can bring your foot just above your knee, not pushing on it. Take your feathers out to the side. Let's try counting to 5 this time. Here we go, 5, 4, 3, my goodness, 2, and 1, and put your foot back down. Well done, seagulls. Just shake your arms out for a minute. That was amazing. In the distance, we can see another boat. I'm not sure about this, guys. I'm not sure if they're friendly or if they're actually might not be as friendly as we thought. But jump your feet together, because I can see on top of their boat, they've got a flag. And for a minute, it looks as if it's got a cross. Can you jump your feet out and reach your arms out? Make yourself into a huge big X flying on the top of their mast. Is their flag, and it looks to me like we've got unfriendly visitors. Clap your hands. For a minute, make yourself a spyglass. Look through your spyglass and just take a good look. See what's happening on top of that ship. Go from side to side. Oh, hang on a minute, everybody. I can see there is a pirate on board. Okay, come back up slowly. Jump your feet together. This pirate has got a bird, a parrot, on one shoulder, and he's got a wooden leg as well. So can you see if you can come into your pirate pose? It's another balance. If you can take hold of your toes, there are several pirates on the ship. Let's count to 5. You ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Doing a great job. And then release your arm down, release your leg down. To show you from this side. Okay, pirates on the other side, get ready to balance, everybody. Okay, here we go. Take hold of the front of your foot. There we go, bring your parrot onto your shoulder. See if you can stand up really tall. We're gonna count to 5 again. 5, 4, keep looking out in front. 3, 2, oh my goodness. Wobbly pirate. There we go, 1, and bring your foot back down. Well done, everybody. I don't know about you guys, but I'm feeling a bit nervous. That boat is getting closer, and there's pirates on the boat. I actually think we might need to jump overboard and get into a smaller boat. Okay, get ready, we're gonna jump. Okay, be mindful when you're doing this. Here we go, we're gonna jump, come back down. We're in the small boat now. Thank goodness for that. I think we're going to be able to go to the island. We've just seen it out in the distance, and I think that's our safest place to go. And that, actually, for a minute, can you just take your legs apart? One of you, I know one of you's got the map. Can you reach out in front? Oh, that's it. Can you pick the map up for a second? And can you just see if you can look over to one side, get the light on the map? And then actually just take it all the way to the other side. It is the right island. Thank goodness for that. Okay, come back to the middle. Okay, everybody, let's get right into the boat and let's see if we can work together now. We all need to find our place in the boat, get comfy. All right, let's find our balance. So we're gonna see if we can take one foot up. You ready? Then the other foot. And then see if you can hold on. That's it. You can hold on to your knees if that feels better for you. All right, well done. We've got to go in the boat a little bit longer. Can you just see if you can bring your arms back? Can you take your arms forward? Oh my goodness, it's tricky. One more time, arms back. Arms forward, last time. Arms back, arms forward. Drop your feet down, hold on to your toes. Ooh, have a little rest for a minute. Goodness me. Wow. And then slowly come back up. Oh my goodness. As we're going along in the boat, right beside us, It's so special. A whole pod of dolphins have come along beside us. Let's see if we can make a dolphin pose together, like the shape of the dolphins that are right next to the boat right now. Okay, get ready. Let's see if we can drop down onto our elbows, bring our hands together, and then let's lift our dolphin tails into the air, okay? Everybody coming up. You can keep your knees bent. Let me see those dolphins. Wow, just imagine right now you're feeling like a dolphin swimming through the waves, fast and strong and full of power, and having a wonderful time because dolphins love to play. Amazing, now come back down. Oh, have a little rest for a minute. That's it, just curl up for a second. And just like our families, dolphins travel in pods. They love to be with their family. They love hanging out, having a great time, just like us today. Now, right on the other side of the boat is something that is the size of a small house. I don't know if you guys know what it is. I bet somebody would be able to guess. Yes, it is a whale shark. So right now, can you see if you can come down onto your tummy? Can you see if you can reach your arms out in front and make them into a little bit of a circle? Just hold on to your forearms. Can you bend your knees and see if you can bring your heels together and make yourself into a beautiful whale? Amazing. All right, the whale is going to come up and take a big breath. So bring your head down for a minute. And then we're going to breathe in, coming up, and then we're going to let some water out by making a sound. Come back down, one more time, breathe in and come up, letting out the sound, coming back down, and then we're going to push ourselves back up because we've arrived onto the island. Can you lift your hips up? Can you walk your feet towards your hands? And then can you come all the way back up slowly? Fantastic. Now, we step onto the island. Can you take a big step? Can you lift up? That's it, we're gonna step onto the island. We've come through the water. Now we're feeling the sand right between our toes. Feels pretty good actually. And oh, amazing, we feel really happy to go. We got away from the pirates and we're on the island, so I feel like we're okay at the moment. Now, all around the island, the whole island is filled with beautiful coconut palms. So let's see if we can make ourselves into coconut trees. All right, so let's take our heel just above our ankle. And then wherever your tree is today, your tree might be here. That might be fine for you if you feel you want to try and take your leg across, or if you feel you want to try and bring your foot up a little bit higher. You can even hold onto it. That's it. Reaching your branches into the air, your beautiful coconut palms, and then try the other arm. And then almost feel the gentle breeze on the island as your leaves are blowing in the wind. Oh, it feels so nice to be on the island, off of the boat, back on land. Amazing. And then let's take our hands down slowly. Beautiful. And bring our feet down to the ground. Let's try the other side, making our beautiful coconut palm again. Can you imagine that you've got roots going right into the island? And you're feeling very, very strong and solid. Okay, that's it. Finding your balance again. Well done, everybody. Good job. And then seeing if you can maybe go here. Maybe this is good for you today. Or maybe you can even lift your foot high onto the inside of your leg. Stretch your branches into the air. And again, just let that gentle breeze. Oh, it's so beautiful. It's amazing. Fantastic. and then coming back down slowly. Well done, everybody. And bringing your roots into the ground. Now, we've got the map. So now it's a case of working out where the treasure is on the island. But we did hear that the treasure is in a cave. So I think we need to get ready to go through the island. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to reach up, clap our hands, and then we're going to come all the way back down to the ground. Now, that's it. I remember somebody said we needed to go through the first clearing of trees until we find a tree that has fallen over and made a plank. I can see that. I can see it. We've walked through the trees and now we've come to it. Oh my goodness. This tree looks like a plank. First, let's see if we can find that shape and make a plank as well today. All right, so what we're gonna do is first we're gonna see if we can lift up into down dog, into our tail, and then for a minute, we're gonna see if we can find a plank. Oh my goodness, we're gonna get really, really strong, just like that tree. We're gonna see if we can do a plank challenge. Are you ready? We need to stay strong. We're gonna count to 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, keep going, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh my goodness, push yourself back to down dog and then walk your feet towards your hands. Come all the way up, clap your hands, bring your hands back to center and walk backwards. We need to cross the plank. So actually, I think you might be able to use the corner of your yoga mat to help you stay really straight on the plank. Okay, so I want you to see if you can actually walk the plank, walk across this tree, because either side is a big river. And I don't want to tell you this, but I am going to tell you, I've just noticed there's crocodiles in the river. Okay, so get ready. 1 foot in front of the other, find your balance. Okay, everybody? All ready, kids, mums and dads, are you ready as well? We're gonna walk across this beautiful big log, this amazing tree trunk, it's like a plank. Keep going, one in front of the other. That's it, a bit further. We're nearly there. 3 more steps, because we've got a challenge coming. Okay, well done, everyone, keep going. All right, now your challenge is you actually have to walk backwards a tiny bit. Okay, because then we're gonna walk out on the other branch of the huge big tree that's fallen over. Here we go, backwards. You're doing really well. Oh, hang on a minute, backwards. Fantastic, well done. Oh my goodness, and then we've made it. Take the feet apart, drop your arms down. Did you feel your arms working then? Lucky, because right underneath us, I saw 2 big crocodiles waiting. Okay, bring your hands out in front. They look as if they are getting ready for lunch. Breathe in, reach your arms apart, just like crocodile jaws. Get ready, we're gonna snap the jaws after 3. 1, 2, 3, snap. Reach your hands, turn your hands over. You ready? Breathe in, stretch out those crocodile jaws. 1, 2, 3, and snap. Well done, and then reach your arms along beside you. Oh my goodness. Okay, we've got to cross the tree trunk. Now, that's right, we've got to go through the tunnel. Somebody said there was going to be this tunnel made from all the plants into one amazing, huge, big woven tunnel. And I can see that's the beginning of the tunnel. Now, you might not have a hula hoop right now, but I want you to imagine you're holding a hula hoop out in front. So take your hands out with me, spread your fingers, hold your imaginary hula hoop, lift it up, that's it, and now imagine you're gonna climb through the tunnel, that's it, pull it down, pull your arms down, that's it, see if you can take your arms all the way down beside you, and then when you get here, I want you to try to lift one leg, ooh, step it out, you ready? Lift the other leg, step it through, well done, and then keep going right down through the tunnel, you're onto the ground now. Fantastic. And then come onto your bottom. goodness me, I didn't know there was going to be so many things to have to go through. Now, well, there's still a few obstacles before we get to the cave, but we are nearly at the treasure cave. We're very nearly there. So, we've got to go over and under a few more times. Reach up, touch the sky. Reach forward, touch your toes. Reach up, roll back, hug your knees to your chest and come all the way up. Reach up, touch your toes. Reach up, roll back, and then come all the way back up again. Last time, touch your toes. Reaching up, coming all the way back, hug your knees and come all the way forward. Oh my goodness, right in front of the cave. Oh, it's so beautiful. I can hear the sound. I can hear the sound of the waterfall. And actually, we're going to come forward. So breathe in, reach your hands up. Breathe out, hands back to center. Now walk your hands forward. We're coming underneath the waterfall into the cave. Oh, it looks amazing. And then, right in front of us is the treasure chest. Come back up. First, I couldn't see it. But now I think we've all seen it because the sunlight is shining on it and we can see this shape of a box. Reach your feet out in front, open up your hands, take your hands behind you, and then let's make the shape of the treasure chest. Lifting up, that's it. See if you can make yourself into a box. Beautiful, we're gonna hold it. See if you can hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and come down slowly. Wow. So amazing, we found the treasure. So as we open up, we've got to open up the box. So for a minute, can you see if you can stretch your hands forward and then almost imagine you're holding the side of the box. Breathe in as you lift the lid up. And then take your hands out to the side. Just look for a minute inside the box. And I want you to see what the treasure is that you found today. And I want you to whisper that treasure into your mum or your dad's ear, or your brother or your sister's. And I'd love the parents, the mums and dads, to share the treasure that you can see inside the treasure box today. Just see if you can take a moment to do that. Because treasure is very unique to all of us. We all see different things as treasure. And then I'm going to tell you what I found in the treasure chest for me today. So taking a minute to share with your mums and dads or your brothers and sisters. Now, when I opened up the treasure box, I saw the box was full of love. I didn't know it was going to be like that. I thought it might be shells, I thought it might be gold coins, because we are on a treasure hunt. But for me today, I found a box of love. And I realized that I could actually give myself lots of love at the moment, and then I could share that love with all my beautiful family and friends, and with all of you right now as well. So that's what I want to do. I want to share the treasure that I found with all of you right now as well. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I think it's time to take your favorite toy and get ready for relaxation, because I think we have had quite an adventure finding the treasure today. Now, when you take your toy and you lie down, what I would love you to do is to put the toy on your tummy today, and then he becomes like a breathing buddy, like a relaxation buddy. So I'm just going to show you how to do that, and then I'm going to read you a beautiful relaxation and play you some music. So if you'd like to lie down next to mum or dad and hold hands, whatever you'd love to do that feels really nice for you right now would be fantastic. So I'm just going to put my beautiful friend Bounce. I'm going to show you what I was talking about and you're going to lie down. And remember, we're going to take our feet a little bit apart. That's it. Okay, and we're going to lie down. And I'm going to put bounce. Oh, actually, I'm going to put him like that because I can stretch his arms out. And I can put him onto my tummy if I want to. I could put my hands on my favorite toy. I could put my hands onto Bounce because that feels really, really nice and relaxing, and it makes me feel very, very calm. Or I could take my hands beside me and put my palms up to the ceiling. Just deciding what feels really nice for me right now. And that's what I'd love you to do. Get yourself very, very comfortable so that you can relax for the next few moments. Because remember, relaxation is very, very special and important in yoga because it's like putting the icing on top of a cake. That's how I see it. Because for me, the relaxation keeps all the sweetness in from all of your hard work and effort and energy today. And then when we keep all that sweetness inside, then afterwards we can share all of that lovely energy from yoga with everybody that we're with today at home, okay? So I'm just gonna find us some really, really lovely relaxation music for a moment. And get us ready to enjoy our relaxation. So I hope you're feeling very comfortable and relaxed right now, lying down on your yoga mat with your mums and your dads, your brothers and sisters. And my goodness, what a big adventure to find that treasure today. So many different things that we saw and experienced along the way. So I'd like you to begin by feeling your body lying very comfortably on the floor right now. Why not imagine for a moment that you're lying in a beautiful opening on the island where there's trees all around us and there's a beautiful patch of grass in the middle where we can lie down very, very peacefully and enjoy the feeling of the soft grass beneath our skin. See if you can start to feel the softness of your breath as you breathe in and out. Notice perhaps your favorite toy or your breathing buddy resting on your tummy. And as you breathe in, feel your tummy rising and your teddy rising or your toy. And as you breathe out, feel your tummy becoming smaller. Imagine for a moment that you're holding a box of love. Can you see what size the box is? Can you imagine what it feels like to hold the box in your hand? Can you imagine what color the love is that's in the box right now? And when you look inside the box of love, how does it make you feel? I wonder what it is that love means to you right now, lying peacefully and calmly on the earth, feeling your body relaxing with every breath that you take. For a moment, I'd like you to think about who you'd like to share that love with right now. Perhaps you'd like to share that love with your mum and dad. Perhaps you'd like to send that love to your grandparents right now, Perhaps you'd like to send that love to your friends or even some of your beautiful animals that you might have in your family. For a moment, as you breathe in, I want you to imagine you're filling yourself up with love. And notice how every part of your body starts to relax a little bit more. Feel your toes relaxing, your ankles relaxing, your knees relaxing, all the way up to your belly button. Feeling your legs relaxing. Feeling your toy resting on your tummy and your tummy relaxing. And then coming all the way up to your shoulders, down to your elbows, down to your wrists and into each and every finger. Now from the top of your head, all the way down to your toes, your body is filled with love in every single place. And you've been sharing that love with everybody who you thought about today. As you breathe in and as you breathe out, quietly, silently to yourself, whispering, I am loving. I am loving. Feeling the love around you and within every part of your body. Just relaxing for a few moments longer. Feeling your body sinking down. Listening to sounds around you, noticing any sounds that you can hear, and then listening for a special sound today. Very, very, very gently, not waking the body up quickly, just letting the body wake up very slowly. Can you wiggle your fingers and your toes? And then can you reach your hands over your head, taking your hands behind you on the floor, stretch out through your fingers, stretch out through your toes, and see if you can find as much space in your body that you've created today. And then see if you can hug your knees towards your chest and then gently roll onto your side and just take a moment there. Just feel how you're feeling right now. It's Sunday, we don't need to jump up and rush around. Enjoy that feeling. And then when you're ready, very, very slowly, when you feel like you'd like to, see if you can bring yourself back up slowly. Coming back up to a seated position. Wow. I know that I feel very peaceful and I feel very grateful right now. very grateful to have the chance to spend this time with you on a Sunday. And I hope you've had a really, really wonderful time. I know I have. And I thought I might take an affirmation card for all of us today. Let me see. I'm going to grab the cards. And let me see if I can find a card for us today. I would love one of you to choose a card for me. I'm just going to imagine that one of you is doing that right now. And wow. This is what I found for all of us today. And today, the affirmation is, my body is strong and healthy. Well, I hope that you are feeling wonderful and fantastic, and I'd like to wish you a very, very beautiful day ahead, whatever your rest of your day is with your family. I would like to express the deepest gratitude for your time, your energy, and your inspiration today.